Hello and welcome to part 9 of the series on how to create the Twitch UI with React.js. In this part we are going to create the streamer section of the sidebar. So last time we have created the recommended channels, which you see right here. Now we are going to create this. So we have already created the section in our sidebar, which is the user section. And in this user section we want to display different users. So the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to upload an image. Well, we are going to import an image which we are going to use for the profiles. So the image that we are going to use is this one, and we are going to drop it inside the public folder. We are going to create a new folder named assets, and inside of here a new folder named images, and right here we are going to drop the bunny like so. And now we are going to create we are going to create the users. So for this tutorial I actually want to create a JSON file for the users so we can dynamically render the users. So for example, say you want to use this for your own project, you're probably fetching a call from the API or something, and you also get JSON back. So the implementation is the same, only this time we are not going to call an API, but we are going to import a local JSON file. So we are going to create a new folder in the source folder, which will be data. And in the data we are going to create a users.json. And inside of here we are going to create one big array of users. So right here we see that we have a user image, we have a user name, the description, and then the amount of people that are watching right now. So the first object that we are going to create will have a username. It will be, for example, let's say LCS. Then we have the image, which will be the image path, and that will be slash assets slash images slash bunny.jpg. And say you fetch something from an API, it will probably look something like this. Instead of this path, it will be like http://, and then www, and then myserver.com/files/, and then one big file name .png, something like this, and then you fetch it from your server. But right now we use the local image right here, so this is fine for now. And then we have the description, which is League of Legends, and then we have the amount of watchers. So let's see, watchers 8.4k. So you could also say, for example, do this, and then you think at the front end at how you want to display it. But you could also do that in the back end already, and you can just return a string of the amount of people who are watching. So this is the first one. Now you're going to create the second one. Route Rust 72.5k. Then we have chess. Chess 30.5k. Like so. And I'm going to do the rest real quickly, so I'll be back in a second. So I have created everything. And I just actually noticed that the numbers are changing, so the watchers, just copy them over, but they are not accurate anymore. But anyways, let's go on with the coding. So now that we have all the data, we want to use it in the sidebar, right here. And we are going to use it by saying import users from data. Users.json. Okay, so We can show the data on the front end by saying users, like so. And if we save this up, it won't show it. So maybe we do to string. Error, okay. So let's see. It's not that easy to show it on the front end actually. But that's okay, that's okay. Because we are actually going to map them to an object. So we're going to say users.map. And we want to map each user to a component. We want to return a div. So. And then we want to render, for example, the user.username. Because if we look at our users.json, they all have a username. So if we do this, we see literally u.username. So I think we should, yes, we should do it in those brackets. Yeah, okay, nice. So now the actual data is being rendered on the front end. So that's actually a pretty big step already. The only thing we need to do is we need to apply some styling actually. And to apply styling, we are going to create a separate class. We are going to create a user class. And in the user class, we are going to create a user.tsx and a user.css. Oh, and one thing that I've noticed is we don't need to import React anymore since the newer versions of React. But I don't know if this project is up to date with the newest version. But we'll find out in a second if we try this right here. So we import the styling. And then we are going to create the for default function user return div. Yes. Now we still need to import React right here. So it's no problem. We just write it like so. We need to add curly brackets, or why is it? Wait, did I write something wrong? Reactive, React from React. Okay, so I need to switch those up like so. Yes. Okay, so now that we have this down, that took longer than it should. We are going to look at what we want to render in our user. So we want to render, let's say, we start with a div. We want an image. Then we want span with the title. So this will, the div will be named user. Image will be named profile picture. Then we have a span which will be the username. Then we have a span which will be description. And then we will have the amount of people watching, the watchers. Like so. And let's fill in some default values. Description, high, watchers, 22k. Remove this, username, Tiki. And then we are going to save this. And not seeing anything. That is because we still need to, render the user right here. So instead of rendering this, we want to return a user, which we have imported from the correct location. And if we save this, we see the username, Kiki, the description, hi, and then the amount of people watching, 72k, or 27, no, 72k, yeah. And then we want to render the profile picture, which will be source, and then we have slash assets, images, bunny.jpg, like so. And we see the bunny appearing, which is way too big. Okay, so before we are going to pass in the real data, I'm just going to really quickly create the class right here. The user class, the user and the profile image. Because I actually want to limit the size of this big picture. And it doesn't look like it was profile picture. Ah, my bad. Yes. So that is way too small. I'm gonna keep it at 32, I think. Yes. And then a border radius. So if you want a circular image, border radius of 50%. Grant. Yeah. So now we have our images appearing. Next, I actually want to import the real data, which we're going to use. So let's see. How do we get data from here into here? Well, we create an interface of properties, and then we pass in the values that we have right here. Well, actually, instead of passing in all the values separately, we're just going to say that it expects a user object. But we don't have a user object, so let's see. We can just for now say any, and then right here we can say instead of hard coding this string, we can say user. We still need to import it right here. So we can say user dot image. That's the name, right? Image, yes. And here we have the username, it's user.username. Description, user.description. And then the watchers is user.watchers. So if we save this, we will get an error, I think. Let's see. Yes, because our user is not getting the variables that it should get. So we need to get the user variable, and we need to pass it in. So the user is equal to you, in this case. And as you can see, our data is being rendered correctly. So that's really good. Next up, we want to... what do we want to do actually first? I think we want to style it a little bit. So how are we going to do that? We can use flex. 1, 2, 3. Columns. Let's see. Okay, I'm just going to think for a second. So there are two ways we can do this. We can do this with flex, or we can use grid. And I think I'm gonna go with a grid. And we're going to do it the same way as we did with the page. Actually, we're going to use template areas. So I'm going to pull this up next to the users, and maybe is it more clear if I put it right here. So here we have the users file and here the app.css file. So we have our user, it will be a grid. Let's see how it looks then. Still the same, nice. we have the grid template areas. Template areas. And then we have, let's see, top left is profile picture. So profile picture. Then we have, next to that is the username. Next to that is the amount of watchers. And then on the next row, we have another profile picture. Or well, not another, but it's two rows high. Then we have the description. And then we have a blank. So I don't know if I should type something in, or we'll just leave a blank. Maybe it works, maybe it won't. We'll see by itself. Then we are going to assign those template areas to the correct class names. So here we have the username, the description, and then at the end we have the watchers. And I'm going to remove the styling actually, because we don't want circular usernames or descriptions. And then I'm going to say this, we want a grid template area, or grid area, which is equal to profile picture. This grid area is equal to username. And this one is equal to description. Oh, and this one to watchers. Like so. So if we save this up, let's see. Yeah. So that's not exactly what I had in mind. But we want to keep it at 32 pixels. Let's see what is actually going on. So first user we have right here. It's everything is just the same width. That's good. But why is it it's all centered, it looks like. And the image is also not really image is on the left side text. Okay. So how are we going to fix this? I actually don't see the user.watchers anymore. Oh god, it's all going down. Do we need to fill in blank something? Oh, okay. Well, okay, problem solved. The issue was that we didn't fill in anything right here. So we do need to fill in something, and I just filled in blank because we are not using that space right there. So this actually already looks like how we want it to. The only thing missing is that we want to add a little padding to it, to the left and right. So right here, we are actually going to do that to the sidebar because everything is set by that little. Well, no, wait, we can't because. No, we cannot because the. You see, when we hover over it, it gets lighter. If we apply the padding to the sidebar, the light area won't touch the sidebar anymore. So we have to apply to the user. We are going to say underneath here, padding 0 pixels, 5 pixels. So horizontally 5 pixels. And now you can see that they are a little bit from the side. 10 pixels. That looks good. Nice. So next up, we want to decrease the size of the username by a little bit. Like so. Then we want to decrease the size of the description by a lot. Not that lot. 0.75. Yeah. Does it matter? Yeah, okay, so it does shrink and grow. Okay, good. So let's see, we then want to pick the color for the description. I hope I can get my color from here. Is this it? No, I think it's... We'll see. Oh, color this. Now, yeah. It's too small to pick the color, so I'm just going to go with this and hope that it looks the same. Way too dark. Then we're going to go with our feelings. And it did update. Yeah, okay, nice. This looks a lot better. So we have LCS, League of Legends, and then we have the amount of watches on the right, which should be the same size as LCS, I think. The font size 0.9 rem. Nice. And then we actually want to display this on the right side. So if we just open up our DevTools, I want to see what's happening right here because all the usernames are not starting exactly at the same position. And I don't know why. It's a miracle to me. I think we need to predefine the sizes of the grid. Let's see. We have our grid right here. Grid template columns. Then the first column will be 22 pixels. And the second column will be auto and auto. Oh, we need a column. Yeah. That works, but now we want to increase this to 48, I think. Yes. Okay, this already looks a lot better because 40. Because everything is aligned to the left, and then this should align to the right actually. So if we say 10 pixels, does that solve it? Yeah, that solves it. But we do need to increase it a little bit. So 30 pixels. Maybe also 50 because we also need the red dot. Oh wait, no, this is not what we want because... No, this is not good. No. We need to make this auto. And then we just need to text align right, I think. Let's see, text align right. Yeah, okay. This is better. Yeah. Then we want to put some spacing between the users. So... next to the padding horizontally, we want to give a padding vertically of 2 pixels, like so. Maybe even 4, that's too much. No, 4 looks good, nice. And we want to have a little spacing between the channels and the users as well. So I'm just going to close this because we don't need it anymore. And we are going to go into the sidebar right here, top section right here. And then we say margin of 10 pixels, 0 pixels. Yes. Oh, that actually looks kind of the same. That's good. Next up, we need a little red dot. So I don't exactly know how we can get that. I think it's just in the text, but it's not. No, it's a red dot indicator. Okay, so let me just red dot. Yes. Okay. We can just copy this. I don't know if it's the best best solution, but this works. I hope it's not too big. It's way too big. Oh man. That's a little bit red.html small. Maybe we have a small version. Well. So what should we do? Should we just live with this and go on, or should we try to make it smaller? If we decrease the font size, actually, does the dot get also smaller? Yes. So the dot gets smaller if we decrease the font size. So we can just say that this is smaller span. Like so. And then we give this a class name of dot, the best naming ever. And then we go to users, watchers, and then in the watchers we have a dot, font size of 0.5 gram. 0.3. What? It's not. Oh, user, sorry. Yay, okay, and then 0.4. 0.5. 0.6. 0.55. Yes, and then we need to center it. So right here, let's see, display flex, align items. Oh. Align items center, yes. And then text align right won't work anymore. So justify content flex end. Yes. And then we want a little spacing between the dots and the text, so margin right of 5 pixels. Yes. Okay, great. Wait, we still need to make the text a little bit different color. So we're going to go with this color. That's too dark. This one. Yeah, it looks a lot better already. Okay, nice. So we have created our users. The last thing that we are going to do is add a little bit more spacing, and we are going to give them a hover. So when we hover over it, we get a mouse pointer, and we get a little light background color. So I'm first going to grab the background color by, let's see, taking the hover, like so, and then we can hippity hoppity get the color. And then we type in user hover. And then we have background color, this one. Oop. Yes. And then we want the cursor or pointer. Yes. Nice. Nice, nice. Okay, username font weight 500. And description maybe also, actually. I don't know. Ah, it's too thick. And we need to space those letters out more, I think. Letter spacing of 0.5 rem. No, 0.2. 0.1. Let's not go with rem. 5 pixels. 1 pixel. Yeah, this looks better, but maybe not the font weight then. Yeah? I don't actually know. I think this looks kind of cool though. Yeah. We're just gonna leave it at this. And I see that the warzone is wrapping to another line. So we can actually prevent this by saying white space to none, I think. No, word wrap, none. Okay, so I found this site, CSS Tricks, and it shows how to truncate text with text overflow ellipses, overflow hidden, and whitespace no wrap. So actually, you see this text here at the bottom, Call of Duty Warzone. We're going to, instead of truncate it right here, we're going to type Warzone. And then in our CSS right here, we're going to say white space no wrap. It's in one line, but now the watchers are pushed to the right. So we say overflow hidden. But now we don't see a nice overflow for the text. So then we say text overflow ellipses, like so. And now we get exactly the same result, which is that the text just truncates with triple dots. So I want to thank you for watching. I hope you could follow along. I hope you enjoyed it. I sure did. Leave a comment down below, like, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye!